The executive has obviously reached a decision, the right decision, I would say, and I'm glad that we now have reached a collective executive position that supports, that is supported by the public health advice. I think that it's a very difficult decision and not something that we take lightly, and we understand that it will impact, you know, gravely on many people's lives, just their own personal freedom, but also in terms of the business community who will be impacted. This is a necessary intervention. It was required because of the current situation we're in the midst of the second wave of the global pandemic, and it is obviously a very worrying situation. But I do think we have to put everything in a context, and the context is that over 3,000 families this year will have an empty seat when it comes to the getting together for Christmas. 3,000 families that have lost a loved one. Over 3,000 families that have lost a loved one. And that's the reality. We're dealing with a very serious and trying position, and I think that this necessary intervention is required in order to get us. It gives us the best hope, actually, of getting into the new year. So I understand that many businesses will be anxious and worried. I've spoken actually this morning to many people involved in the close contact services who tell me that actually that they understand that why the intervention is necessary, but they're really, really annoyed that they still haven't received their funding from the Department of the Economy. So the executive needs to now turn its head very quickly to making sure that every penny of financial support is got out into people's pockets immediately. We need to make sure that we continue to talk to all those sectors that are impacted and make sure we support them through this very difficult period. So I just want to say that I accept how challenging this is. This is a necessary intervention. I'm glad the executive has now arrived at this position. Our job has to be support those people that have been impacted, and our job also has to be working towards what comes next. And I think that what comes next is where we see developments with the vaccine, where we see developments with mass testing, and I certainly am going to work with all executive colleagues to make sure we give people that hope and that light at the end of the tunnel.